Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Cameryn and I make anything on this channel from college lifestyle to Disney related content. And as you can tell by the title of today's video, today I'll be doing yet another Apple video. If you did not know, I have a whole playlist full of all my tech unboxings to Apple review product videos on my channel. I'll have it displayed here as well as linked in the description, or you can click the I to check all my other Apple videos out. I actually recently did an Apple TV unboxing, so if that interests you, be sure you check out that as well. But today I'm going to be starting this mini series on my channel, and I'm going to be calling it my Apple Week. So to start and kick off Apple Week, today in this video I'm going to be showing you guys what is on my iPhone. I have in the past couple of years have done what's on my iPhone videos, and they're absolutely one of my favorite videos, not only to film but also to watch. I'm very curious to see what other YouTubers and content creators have on their phone, so I will have those linked in the description for you guys to go check those out as well. But yeah, be sure if you haven't already, you give this video a thumbs up, comment down below what other videos you want to see from me in the future, and if you're not subscribed to my channel already, be sure you subscribe, click the red button down below. I'm trying to hit 10,000 subscribers by the end of this month, being January, so it would really mean a lot, and you'd really help me out if you subscribe to this channel so you'll be notified every time I post a new video. But I'm going to stop rambling and we're going to hop right into this video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scoot over to this side of the camera and I'm going to put my iPhone on this side so you guys can see. And what I'm actually also going to do is I'm going to screen record my phone and you guys are going to see exactly what I'm seeing. So let me go ahead and do that really quick. So the first thing is my blue collage lock screen that I have on my phone. And then the first thing you see on my phone is the weather app in the corner, which I know where the weather is, and as well as the calendar widget icon, so I can know what events I have coming up for that day. Also, I have the music widget, which is used quite a lot simply because I am a Hamilton fanatic. I'm always listening to Hamilton on my phone and my AirPods, so a necessity, and it's just right there ready for me to listen to it. And that was actually, fun fact, the last song that I listened to, specifically the last specific Hamilton song that I listened to is What Did I Miss, that David Diggs sings as Thomas Jefferson. That's my favorite. I absolutely love it. So then my last widget on my first my first iPhone screen is a picture, a photos icon. And the cool thing about this is every time that I go on my phone and just I'm scrolling through my apps on my phone, a new picture from my camera roll will randomly pop up and have for me to look at and remember. And it's really cool. I really love this new feature Apple put, because I can look at past memories. I saw a picture from when I went to Ecuador a year ago on there, and just from high school, and even some college pictures have been on there. So it's definitely a nice reminder. This is just a picture of me and my parents at my senior night for my marching band, when I was in high school my senior year. And so this definitely brings back memories. And fun fact, I played the trumpet. It was an adventure, and it's honestly, I think, the best instrument. So comment below if you were a trumpet player. I'm very interested in if you were in general just playing an instrument in marching band, or in high school in general, or right now in college or in life. Definitely let me know. I'm very curious. So that's the photos app. And then the second widget that I have on my phone face is the recently used apps. And I absolutely love this too, because simply sometimes I don't feel like scrolling through all my different categories that I have for my apps, which I'll show you in a bit. It's a lot, but it's categorized and it can get hectic sometimes looking for specific apps. So it's nice here that I have all my recently used ones. So personally for me, I recently used Gmail, LinkedIn, TikTok, Target, Instagram, PayPal, Canvas, and Amazon. So those are my recently used apps. So the next I keep saying watch face because it reminds me of a watch face on like an Apple Watch, but phone face is the motivation widget, which I have every single time I get on my phone and I'm just scrolling, a new motivational quote will pop up and just remind me of different things in life and just the future, I guess. And I love this because it always brings motivation to me and it always makes me feel good. So the quote we have today is, every time you get upset at something, ask yourself, if you were to die tomorrow, was it worth wasting your time being angry? So motivation for your day. And I absolutely love it. It's really, really useful. So I highly recommend if you have an iPhone or an iPod or any Apple product that has the iOS 14 update that you install that on your phone. So the next widget I have is the batteries widget, which I have quite the handful of Apple products. I have AirPods, iPhone, iPad, MacBook, my Beats can even show sometimes on here, as well as an Apple Pencil. And as you can tell, that is quite a bit of Apple products to go through and make sure that everything is charged up. So that's really nice and handy that I can always know when my stuff is charged. And right now everything is obviously at 100 because before filming this, I pre-charged everything. The next thing I have is the podcast widget, which if you did not know, I do have a podcast. I run it with one of my best friends from college, Faith Metellus. The link to it will be linked in the description or in the eye in the corner. It's called Current Talk. We do new episodes every Wednesday mornings, and it's honestly so much fun. Faith, if you're watching this, hello. We have a lot of guests that we are having on our podcast within the next couple of weeks, as well as just a lot of exciting podcast guests that we're hoping to get on in the future. So definitely check that out. So the next thing is the fitness widget, which is currently at zero because I have not exercised today. But normally when I would go for a run or I would just exercise watching like a workout video with my Apple Watch on, it will automatically go on my phone and I can just track how many steps I've taken and all that fun stuff. But I've been just around the house, so I haven't done that much today, so it's at zero. But it's there when I do am very active. And I forgot to mention this, but my bottom apps are the phone app, which is typical, the mail app, the Safari app, and the music app. So there we go. This is just another page full of my typical iPhone apps, Apple apps that we all have, Messenger. I'm not gonna go through all of them. I'm sure you guys already know what they all look like, but these are just the ones that come with the iPhone that I use when needed, and just they're there for me to use when I need to. And then this is really the last one that I have on my phone. And it has all of my apps on my phone categorized. And if I went through every single one of these apps, in today's video, it would be like probably 5 hours long. So we're just gonna go in and see like a glimpse of all the apps I have in these things. So the first app that I have that's not in a folder is called Dream Apps. And Dream Apps is this really cool thing that where you can count down days to different events in your life. So I have my birthday, Halloween, Christmas, and just when I go on trips and I'm counting down to vacation days, I'll have those in there. So that's really nice. But yeah, I gotta put a couple things in there because I have a couple of trips that are coming up that I want to count down to. So definitely want to update that. And then we have just the Apple app that has like the occasional iMovie, Remote, Clips, Keynote, Pages, all that fun Apple stuff. Then I have the books folder, which has Kindle, Bible, this Bible learning app, and Medium, which I don't really exactly remember what that is. I think it's a note-taking app for the Bible. The next folder I have is my education folder. I have Duolingo, Quizlet, which is a lifesaver in college, Kahoot, used that in high school, my Spanish dictionary, the regular Merriam-Webster dictionary, National Calendar Day, which let's see what today's national day is. Today is National Buffet Day, National Personal Awareness Day, National Science Fiction Day, National Cream Puff Day, and National Braille Literacy Day, and more days, but we're not going to go into it for the sake of today's video. And then I actually recently discovered this from one of my friends in high school. I don't remember her name, but it's basically where you get to open the apps. I'll open that for you guys. And what you do is that, oh, how old are you? 19. A student. Okay. So what you do is you take pictures of math problems and it will give you the answer. So if there's any high schoolers or college that need that, highly recommend you download that. It was a lifesaver for me my first semester of college and I had to take a lot of math classes. All right, so going into the next folder, All right, my camera died, so I have to charge it really quick. But going back into the entertainment folder, we have YouTube. Obviously, you're watching this video. You know what YouTube is. Netflix, Disney Plus, HBO Go, Hulu, American Idol, Fandango, and Flixster. And those are like movie rating apps. And then in the next entertainment folder, we have Ticketmaster, Eventbrite, SeatGeek, Fox Theater, Coachella, StubHub, my local movie theater ticket app, and AMC Theaters. And obviously with the pandemic and everything going on, I won't, especially within the next couple of months, not be using that. But when it is safe to start buying tickets for like concerts and some movie tickets and stuff, I will be buying those. So those are there. And I think that's it for the entertainment app. Yes. Okay. So next we have the exercise app, and I have Strava, Map My Run, and Ember. And I mostly use Strava just because I was used to using that a lot in high school, because when I was on cross country, we had to record ourselves running every single time they ran. My old high school cross country and track coach said all the time that if it's not on Strava, it doesn't count. So that's like where we keep all of our workouts. So I have that there. And then next is my finance folder, which I have my bank app, which I use the USAA, Cash App, one of my college organizations, Pay App, PayPal, Every Dollar, Zelle, Venmo, Mint, Robinhood, Goal Setter, and Current. And then for games, I have a lot of games that I actually need to go through and delete, but this is just a plethora of all the games I have. I'm not going to go through all of them because that would take forever. But my favorite game out of all these is 2048, which I think a lot of you guys have played. The next app that I have, or folder of apps that I have, is my Google folder, and I just have all the Google apps from Gmail, Google Earth, Google Drive, Google Chrome. All the typical Google apps are there. I have my home app, which has just a lot of like home related apps, so like my period app, my church app, I have clock, I have my doctor hospital app, and then just like other home related apps on there. Yeah. And then music, I have Shazam, Pandora, Metronome, just other radio stations. And then that was linked to my marching band's halftime show when I was a senior in high school. The next folder apps is my social apps. So this is all my social media apps from Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Pinterest, just Messenger apps, and then all that, you know, random apps that we have in our apps. And then next, this is actually a frequently used folder. I have my stores app. This is where I do all my mobile shopping on my phone. The most used one on here is definitely Amazon, but occasionally Target will be a big one, as well as Walmart. So this is just all my apps that I shop with. It's really bad. And then for my travel folder, I have my airline, which I use Southwest Airlines when I travel, fun fact. So that's my airline app. I have Amtrak, which is for buying train tickets, Uber, which we all know what Uber is, Six Flags, Disney World, flights, Airbnb, travel packing list apps, and all that stuff for traveling. For navigation, I have Glimpse, Google Maps, Waze, Yelp, just like for if I need to find a way to go places, because I prefer using Google apps over Apple Maps because it's more specific. The next folder of apps I have is college, and this is just all of my college related apps that I have here that I use when I'm in school. And then my YouTube app, this is where I track all my analytics for my channel, respond to comments, find video ideas, look at just like a lot of different things. And yeah, so that's my YouTube app. The next folder of apps I have is my food app. So this is where Postmates, Uber Eats, DoorDash, just specific restaurant apps that I eat at frequently that give you rewards if you eat there enough. And yeah, so all that is in there. Then I have my photo and video folder, and this is where I edit all my Instagram pictures, mostly thumbnails if I'm not editing on my MacBook, and just like other apps that I can use to edit stuff for TikToks, because if I wanted to edit a TikTok, I can right there. And then Just other stuff that I can organize my Instagram feed and stuff. So then we have utilities. This is where FaceTime, contacts, I can screen record things from my phone, calculator, and just other Apple apps that I don't really use that much. And then I have my podcast app, which this is where I make just graphics and stuff for the podcast, track the analytics of it, reach outs, and just listening to different platforms and sharing my podcast too. If there's someone that I know that I want to share my podcast with, there's a different plethora of options they can use from Apple, SoundCloud, and Spotify, and just more platforms. We're on like 7 different platforms, so that's really exciting too. Then in my second to last folder, I have jobs. So I have my LinkedIn, just places where I can look at, you know, future internships and future job opportunities, and then all that, you know, appointments and stuff. And then my last folder apps is networking. So this is where I get a lot of brand collaborations, sponsorships, and just I keep all those in one spot so I can track everything and know when I have to work on everything. But other than that, you guys, other than the typical iOS 14 app library, this is all my apps organized from, you know, Apple doing it for me. That is it for my what's on my iPhone video. I really hope you guys enjoyed seeing what's on my iPhone. I had so much fun filming it. This is, again, one of my favorite type of YouTube videos to watch, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Definitely comment below if there's any other Apple related videos you want to see from me. I will have another Apple related video coming on Wednesday. That will be my what's on my iPad video. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below other videos you want to see from me in the future. And if you're not subscribed to my channel already, be sure you subscribe. Click the red button down below. I'm trying to hit 10,000 subscribers by the end of this month, so it'd really mean a lot if you subscribe to this channel and help me out there. And all my social media links and podcasts and all my links will be linked in the description of today's video, so definitely go check out all that. And I'm gonna end the video here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys in my new video on Wednesday, which will be what's on my iPad. Bye.